those.
Yeah.
Seeking that third.
Okay, dear photogrammetry class students, good time of the day in your latitudes and longitudes. And today we are starting a new topic. And this topic is about aerial triangulation or triangulation. And if you look through the scheme of modern photogrammetric workflow, you can see that how each photogrammetric business operates. And what is omitted here, this is real flights. You fly Cessna, you fly drone, but then you get or film if you have hard copy camera, or you have digital imagery, which is most of likely you will get from whatever you will use from DJI or other sensors. If you have film, then you have to scan your data. And what is used, I use special photogrammetric scanners with resolution of 3 microns. And by the way, price of such a scanner is about $60,000. You cannot scan it on regular scanner, which you use to scan your documents. And then major process, as I said, orientation, right? You understood that without orientation, you cannot produce any data from imagery. And after orientation, you have 3 processes and 3 major kinds of products which we produce in photogrammetric production. And first is feature collection, which is exactly what you've done with StereoJS Lab, you should be done with StereoJS Lab. Then you have digital terrain model generation, which is production of matrices of heights with imagery, which can be used in different renderings from computer games till Intel and other applications. And finally, whenever you have DTM and whenever you have orientation, you can produce orthophoto exactly in the way which we discussed, right, when we discussed rectification. So basically, this is a whole spectrum of processes which are in photogrammetric production. And today we will talk about the central one, which is orientation and triangulation. And basically, what is motivation for developing of triangulation technologies, right? So certainly major price, right, major dollar amount will be spent on ground control, right? Because the most expensive thing is, it's not expensive to fly a drone, right? It's a little bit more expensive, but still less expensive to fly airplane like Cessna, right? And again, satellite imagery you can sometimes get for free, but in order to get results, as you learned, you have to have control points. And when we spoke about single model, or how I call it lonely model, right? For lonely model, we need 4 points. So it means we need to collect in the field 4 control points. And the idea of the photo triangulation is, okay, can we get less control points and still get our imagery be coordinated? For example, if we have 100 images, right, which is 99 stereo pairs, right? So usually we have control on the first stereo pair and the last stereo pair. So, but if we will do individual stereo pair controls, how many we need points, if we will use it the same way which we used before with lonely models?
Series.
No, control points.
Control.
Four for each stereo pair, to about 200. So we need to go to the field and measure 4 points, and this is called strip. This is strip. Okay. But usually we fly that way, right? This is a technology which you implemented with a drone fly on your test object in a deck, right? So we have a couple of strips, and this one is already block. Block consisting of n strips. And then you need control not here, but here and here. And here and there. So you have four control points, but for 1,000 images, right? 100 images per strip, 10 strips, 1,000 pictures, right? Four control points. Instead of, you can multiply 200 control points if you use for each stereo pair. So this is major idea. So idea is about what we can do to densify control by measuring imagery instead of going to the field and measuring something on the left. And this process is a typical aryptogrammetric process. It's called phototriangulation or triangulation. And this is typical, you can see, block adjustment scheme. So you can see that each number here stands for stereo pair. And as I mentioned, you have control at the edge of stereo pair. But you can see that there are few points in the middle. And these points don't need to have X and Y. They need to have just Z. What is the reason? Why it happens? So basically, the reason that we use it is usually if we have a strip, so our deformation will be, instead of like non-deformated strip, we will have strip which will be deformated. And the most deformation will be certainly in between the points. So we'll have a little deformation here, a little deformation here, right? And this equation of this line called hyperbolic paraboloid. So I don't bother you with equations, you can always find it in wiki. But the idea is you have deformation of the strip where in the middle, right? And therefore you can see that these hit points are somewhere in the middle here. Okay? And hit points should be something which, I mean, we will talk about control points in a separate discussion, but you have to select points in the right way. And if you will select the height point, let's say top of the building, it will not be a good point, right? I'm always joking that ideal vertical point is a cow poop, right? Because it's on the ground, it's conformed surface of the earth. So if you can locate it, you can measure it, it's ideal point. Something which belongs to the surface, which you're interested in. Something which has a height is not good point, right? Everybody agree on that, right? Because we want our surface to be so-called, we have to bare earth, right? Because except on top of bare earth, we have vegetation, we have trees. We are not interested in trees, we're interested in earth. Okay, so this is motivation about block triangulation. And what we can see here, you can see just projection rays, right? Which all of these lines is what equation? Projection center, image, and point belong to the same straight line. Collinearity. So this is collinearity equation. And for each point, you can produce a lot of collinearity equations. Right? If this point is visible in one image, it's one collinearity equation. This point is visible on two images, it's two collinearity equations. Right? If this point is visible on three images, and there are some points in the middle of the block which will be visible for four images, you will have four collinearity equations for that point. What you have? Your favorite stuff, redundancy, least square adjustment. So if the unknowns of these points are x, y, and z, so you can get it from four collinearity equations. This is what photogrammetric adjustment is about. And what are unknowns? What is the structure of the block adjustments? So, we have, let's say, M is number of strips, right? M is number of strips, N is number of images per strip, photos in the block, right? So what we have to know about each of these photos, right? We will have to know X center, Y center, Z center, right? Omega, phi kappa. And this is for photo one, right? The same we have for photo two, etc. How many these unknowns will be? 6 multiplied by m by n, right? We have m strips, m pictures, we multiply m by n by 6. This will be unknown elements of exterior orientation. So 6 multiplied by m by n. If m is 100, n is 100, then whatever you will get in the end. Okay? What else? If you look to this scheme, right, you can see that some of these points are tie points, some of these points are any points you measured for triangulation, right? Let's say you have also K points. You have also K points, which are your tie points, control points, anything what you included. So total number of unknowns will be M by N by 6 plus K multiplied by 3. Right? Because for unknown points, we have X, Y, and Z. So each point which is included in triangulation process will get as a result adjusted X, Y, and Z. And there are also cases when you want to include your interior elements of interior, F, X, 0, Y, 0, right? And it's called self-calibration. If you include also these parameters, you have to add here plus m by 3, it comes for self-calibration. So you also make corrections to elements of exterior orientation. Large matrices, right? In your adjustment courses, you resolved like for 2 points, right? For 3 points. Now this you resolve for hundreds of points, but solution is the same. It's least squares adjustment. Okay, technologically, what we are getting from for the triangulation? We get, as I mentioned, all parameters of exterior orientation for each images which included into block. And we look to overlap at least 60%. Now, why you think 60%? We spoke about it when we spoke about von Gruber points.
This is enough
for... Oh, because if you will not have 60% overlap, right, some type points which are included in stereo pair 1, 2 will not be visible in stereo pair 2, 3, right? If, let's say...
I'll make a graphical illustration.
Let's say you have, let's discuss it on sample of three images. You have image one, right? Image two, and image three. One, two, three. Okay, this is overlap of image 1 and 2, stereo pair 1. And this is overlap of image 2 and 3, right? And what is this? This is overlap of all three of them, right? So that's why 60% is a minimum. Because if you will not have 60%, you will not have this overlap, right? And this point has collinearity to this image, but it will not have collinearity with next developer. Our connection will be broken. So it's like, imagine we just use a needle and we sew this three images together, right? When we sew with a needle, we have to have some box in triple overlap. So that's why 60. Speaking of UAV, 60 is not good enough. Because we will discuss it in flight planning lecture, but if you will do set up 60 on your UAV autopilot, right, and you will have gun wind gust or such, it will suddenly get 40, right? You will have gap in your image, and you will have to refly your object. So therefore, for 60 is a kind of standard for Cessna, for aerial image acquisition, and at least 80 is a standard for UAV. And lap between strips is a side lap, right? And side lap is approximately choose to be 25%. Again, why? Because you want to collect points which should be visible on both strips, right? This is how we can connect two strips. Only by common type points. Only by common von Gruber points, if you want, right? So if I have here another strip, right? And I have here a point. This point will be visible on three stereo pairs and on two strips. This point will have six collinearity equations at the same time. Right? So this way, magic least square will work. But to make least square work, we at least have to have the same point, right? To be measured from different photos. You feel analogy with classical surveying, right? If you want to connect, right? If you want to connect point to several controls, right? More controls you use, more accurate you are, right? Same thing here. Just you observe your control instead of observing like its visibility on the ground, you observe it from the top. This is all the difference. And basically, whatever you will get from, certainly whenever you get six elements of exterior rotation for each image, they can be used for auto production, right? If you measure during triangulation extra points, later these control points can be used as a control point. Because they will have X, Y, and Z adjusted based on accuracy of your photogrammetric measurements, right? And then on the ground, you can use this as a control. So therefore, another definition of triangulation is control densification. Right? From sparse control, like for geodetic points at the edge of a block, right? The big area, we make every hour type point to become control point. And certainly, feature extraction of stereo imaging is not possible if you don't have this orientation element. Okay. And basically, what can be used as a point for the triangulation block adjustment? So, Certainly, some points can be marked. So basically what is happening, you place on the ground something which will be visible, right? And you compute what could be visible from yourself. What is your resolution, right? And if you place something which is not visible, which is less than resolution, it will not be visible. So in our lab we have cardboards, if you place to be visible from UAV. Certainly natural points. On your lab, you saw very good natural points, like crosses on the road, right? Like corners of the building, etc., which are very good natural points. And the problem is not always you have natural points. If you will process images, I don't know, for Air Force, Army, from territory of Iraq, it will be very difficult to find any points. You see just desert and one road going through desert. Okay. And certainly artificial, in this case artificial points are used. And block adjustment, basically major adjustment is you in 100 times you decrease need in the ground control. Yeah, because as you can see this figure, right, this point is measured everywhere and it became ground control. And certainly these triangulated points might not be used for real construction surveying purposes, because you're looking to accuracy of a couple of centimeters in most of cases. Right, and in the kind of construction surveying, we are looking to sub-centimeter accuracy, a couple of millimeters. It's very difficult to achieve this kind of accuracy from IRL triangulation. Accuracy like that can be easily achieved with close range cases. Let's say I was involved in triangulation of surface of radio telescope. And you know what radio telescope is?
Yes.
Yeah, its diameter is about 200 meters. And
look, your curve. You have central antenna, but you have like kind of elements of antenna which are oriented. To focus energy like to the central antenna. And requirements for the, you understood the idea, but you can Google radio telescope, you'll see what is that. The question,
the only application of this RI is, you know, capturing the sky.
Whatever you capture. Because for radio telescope, we use camera on the ground, and we achieved accuracy of 0.2 millimeters with certain camera. That camera was stationary installed in the middle. And this, by the way, this telescope is in Armenia. And Armenia has the largest radio telescope in the world. And it's in the Ararat Mountains, one of highest radio telescopes. So again, you will not be able to achieve this kind of accuracy from DJI Phantom or DJI Inspiron images. And certainly not from even use Leica scanner, you will not achieve it. But there are few applications, respectful applications, where this accuracy is sufficient. So first, certainly intelligence, right? Couple of centimeters for Intel is okay. Another respectful application is cadastral survey. For cadastral, we don't need this kind of accuracy. Couple of centimeters would be okay. The same for boundary. Okay? So we don't need high accuracy. And another interesting application is ground deformation and monitoring. And most of you took class of geospatial monitoring and photogrammetric triangulation. This is exactly what is used for this kind of applications. And certainly for urban surveys. So whenever we observe some landscape development, triangulation or block, this kind of technology that can be deployed there on imaging side if imaging sensors are involved. And also for traditional land surveying, as I mentioned, you can use it to define coordinates of section corners and also aerial triangulation can be used as kind of checking tool to detect blunders in ground control. So instead of coming to the field, if especially if the field is not accessible or far away, and you have imagery, you can perform triangulation, right? And you will check if your coordinates you get from triangulation are in sum of tolerance, so maybe you are okay. If totally out. I believe Trimble Business Center has triangulation capability because Trimble robotic station is equipped with a camera. And idea is everything, something you forgot to measure in the field, you can then measure on the Trimble Business Center with photogrammetric triangulation capabilities. So this technology is implemented also in TBC, in Trimble Business Center. I believe we have, I believe license is working, hopefully, and we can run it from our labs. So now let's talk about methods of aerial triangulation. I mean, not really mathematics, but technology. And if you will look papers, if you look textbooks, you will find maybe 50, maybe 60 ways of performing triangulation. But all of them can be divided into general, right? Without specifics, then can be divided into two groups. First group is called independent model triangulation, and second group called bundle adjustment. Okay, so now let's discuss what independent model triangulation is. So, in, as you can see, in independent model triangulation, you perform coplanarity equation, right? You find you measure six tie points, right? And you define first coplanarity. You build free model, and then you connect stereo pairs by common points. And usually you build strip like connecting more and more stereo pairs. And then you hurry. This is just the way how we discussed was implemented in analog devices, right? So first you apply coplanarity without using of collinearities, and then after you build strip. But how you build strip? You build it certainly in a free model, right? So basically you build everything with respect to the free system of the first stereo pair of your strip. So you basically got something like if this is my first stereo pair, right? I establish my system, let's see, right? This is XYZ, this is my second stereo pair. So I connect everything to that system. Whatever I got is measured in this system, which has origin in projection center of your very left image, right? Beginning image of the strip. And certainly, as we spoke, in this free model, you will get very negative Z values, right? Because your point of beginning is in the sky with the image, right? And your model coordinates are coming down. And then whenever you build it one by one, and why it was convenient? It was convenient for simple reason that this technology could be realized without computers. Right? If I have analog device, right? I measure six tie points. I use my buttons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? I have them on the map. Right? Then I connect second stereo pair and I use the same 3 points which are in a 60% overlap. I just switch analog images in the analog device, right? But all my triangulation happens where? Happens on this piece of paper, right? Block is really block, but this block consists of points on the paper, right? And all measurements I make. And what is advantage, and again, now this method is certainly rarely used, but still used, and we still have to recognize importance of coplanarity equation. Why? Somebody has an idea why? You did it many times. What coplanarity equation helps you to reduce, to identify? What was your fight during your stereoscopic experiences?
Parallax.
Okay. So problem is if you made mistake in measurements, right? In independent models matter, you will see large parallax on where you made a mistake, and you will remeasure this point or remove this point, right? In contrary, this computer vision approach called Bounded Adjustment, which works with collinearity only, right? If you have, you measured hundreds of points, and you have parallax in one of them, what this point will do? It will destroy all your block, right? Especially, so you'll see, I am kosher, right? I am halal. I made everything correct, but my parallax is so large. And it's not easy to really identify which point has been large parallax in bundle adjustment, because all these matrices, m by n by 6 plus m by 8 by n by 3 by m by k by 3, right? It is a large matrix, and it's not really easy to detect blunder in that case. Therefore, many of softwares, they still run independent models, but for each model, right? So if we have 900 models, I will run, computer, not me, I will run coplanarity equation, and I will see models, and again, if model parallaxes all 6 points are okay, I shouldn't do nothing with this model. But if I see, okay, this model has 5 millimeters parallax, I should pay attention to this model. And only after then I run bundle, right? So independent models cannot be fully, and this is, by the way, I believe, advantage of photogrammetric approach to triangulation compared to computer vision. Because in computer vision, if you have blunder, you have blunder, so nothing works. In photogrammetry, we came from history of using analog devices, and we know that blunders are fundamental properties of any measurements, especially student measurements, right? And independent model and relative orientation and coplanarity equation is our instrument to get rid of blunders. Okay. This is, and again, it's mathematically, it's not too much of effort and too much of processor time. But this is, so say, technological or methodological approach, if you wish, to resolve the problem. And what is bundle? Bundle is just dealing with collinearity equations. Right? In bundle, I don't care about any parallaxes, because each projection ray, each ray which has projection center, image XY on the image, XYZ on the ground, is a collinearity equation. What I do, I resolve just matrix. Size of the matrix, you got the size. M by N by K by 6, very large matrix. If I will write for block 10 by 10, this desk will be small. How many numbers I have to write? Large matrices. And here is exactly a scheme of bundle adjustment. So in bundle adjustment, as you can see, each ray here represents collinearity equation, which you know, which we discussed, right? And we are just looking for unknown parameters. And this approach, how we get to unknown parameters, is standard least square approach. Please remind me, if we have equations containing unknowns, what we have to do? I guess your favorite things to do with these equations, to get from unknowns to parameters and to get from parameters to corrections, what we do? We do your favorite stuff called partial derivatives, right? Partial derivatives of these equations
Sorry, John. I cannot say it another way. We will discuss later. So basically, if you have equation and we have unknown parameters, right? We have to differentiate to get, and this differentiation will give us what? Will give us functional kind of coefficient, right? Coefficients for what? For least square adjustment. So basically, least square adjustment in photo triangulation is not different from least square adjustment from transit, for triangulation, for trilateration, for everything what we use on the ground. We use the same approach for bundle block adjustment. And computer vision use the same approach, because this is the only approach which computer vision can use, and for just collinearity. Except of one thing which computer vision may use, instead of sensor parameters, computer vision may use so-called DLT algorithm. Have you heard about it?
Direct linear control.
DLT. And the difference of DLT between collinearity is, in DLT, we don't have our interior elements of interior orientation being involved. DLT was proposed by American photogrammetrist. His name was Dr. Carrara. Was proposed in 1976, I think. Maybe wrong, 70s, 80s. And the idea of DLT is, okay, direct linear transform. And you can find formulas. They are not much more complicated than formulas. Formulas we consider it here for collinearity are more complicated. But if you want to use DLT method for triangulation, it's still applicable for bundle. Then you have to have 8 tie points instead of 6 tie points. Because we spoke that when we spoke about coplanarity equation, right? 5 parameters, 6 points. In DLT, there are 7 parameters, and you have to have 8 points for DLT. When you may use DLT, let's say you have, I know Sanjay has some drone with a non-calibrated camera, so kind of toy drone, right? So we may not anticipate Sanjay will have F parameters of interior orientation for his drone, right? Then the DLT is an option, because collinearity in this case will not work. Right? To execute collinearity, you remember that x0, y0, and principal focal distance are parameters which have to take place. But you have to get these parameters from where? From calibration. So your camera should be calibrated. And if your camera is not calibrated by collinearity, by photogrammetry, hello, DLT. And I believe in computer vision, you use it a lot, right? DLT. Okay, but still, doesn't matter. Idea of triangulation is for DLT, you just need more control. Right. And another thing which may kill DLT, if you have at least 2 of your tie points being of the same type. And this is just a computational thing. So in DLT, you have to take care of all your tie points are on different heights. If they are on the same, at least 2 of them, follow from computer vision. Okay, but both methods, certainly preferable method is photogrammetry, because you use physical sensor model, you use model of real physical parameters also central. But you can do triangulation with DLT if you don't have good camera, I mean, you don't have calibrated camera. Right. It's also the work. And as a result, what you will get? You will get a very large matrix. For each equation, you will have coefficients which will come from partial derivatives of the collinearity equations. Right? You remember collinearity equation, like x minus x0. I will write it this way.
rotation matrix, right? A11. Three multiplied by x1 6 0, y1 y0, -7. Right?
You remember this big formula.
So basically, to get to triangulation, I have to take, and I'm looking for partial derivatives. If I want correction to x center, I don't differentiate this. This is equation A1. I will take partial derivative d of A1. By d x c, I will get a formula.
To be honest, nowadays you have tools like Mathematica, like MATCAD, and you may not, because differentiation is part of process, right? Everybody took calculus, everybody took partial derivatives. You remember, this is a pain. So indeed, if you will be in position, you have to do partial derivatives of collinearity equation. Please use MATCAD. So just, you have to write them correctly and then write command. And moreover, what is really good about these tool sets right now, you can even say one of parameters, if you want to, what kind of source code you want to have for partial derivative. You may get it in C, you may get it in Java, on Python, etc. So basically, don't be afraid to be in project like that when you have to take partial derivatives. Okay, and certainly you train your will, you train your character when you do it on like this paper and pencil, right? But there are tools which you can easily do it without it, so it's doable. And you have to know just how to use MATL, how to use NETCAD, tools like that, that they have. And I believe MATLAB also have some tool set for getting partial derivatives with simple command. And your response for MATLAB will be this partial derivatives. Okay, certainly a large number of projects may consist of hundreds of modules. And certainly application of this method enables to save a lot of thousands of dollars for big projects, because you don't need, you decrease in 100 times number of surveying hours. Or then you replace it by just clicking the image. Okay, I think we are out of time, and we will continue this discussion on Wednesday. Hopefully, Stereo.js will work. Okay, thank you.